morning, you're watching Proactive London, and joining us today from IXICO, we have the CEO, Giulio Cerroni. A very good morning to you, Giulio.
Good morning, Katie.
So you've just published your financial results for the year that ended September 2020. Before that, do please remind our audience who IXICO are and the market that you address.
Sure. So IXICO was established in 2004, and we've been listed on AIM since 2013. We're a medical imaging technology company providing analytical services to the global pharmaceutical industry. We provide specialist data analytics for brain scans that are used in clinical trials for companies focused on developing therapies for neurological conditions such as Parkinson's disease, Alzheimer's, and Huntington's disease, just to name but a few. In terms of the market that we address, our management estimates is that the addressable market for what we do today is between 125 to 150 million pounds. So whilst we've more than trebled revenues in the past 4 years, we believe there's still lots of runway with growth with sort of less than 10% market share that we hold today. So we see continued growth opportunities in that market. More specific details for your listeners are actually available and published on clinicaltrials.gov, which is a registry of all the clinical trials that are running and are about to be started. But some of the large pharma companies that are running trials in this space are companies such as Roche, Biogen, Eli Lilly, Takeda, Eisai, again, just to name but a few, but also a number of emerging biotech companies as well. So those are the sort of market sizes and the sort of clients that that we look to serve.
Excellent. Now, reverting to today's full year results for 2020, the fiscal year, can you provide more detail behind the significant revenue growth and more than doubling of your profits?
Yeah, sure. And again, just in some context, this is the fourth year of very strong financial performance. So this year specifically, finishing September, we delivered 26% revenue growth up to 9.5 compared to last year's 7.6 million. And that's a 4 year compound growth rate of 33%. So we're very pleased with that, of course, and demonstrates the company's ability to continue on that rapid growth trajectory. Mm-hmm. I mean, the other thing as well to say is that this top line growth has also been associated with continued strong margin. We're very pleased with that. And so that really sort of talks to the operational leverage that we've achieved and benefited from in growing, but also the fact that we've signed up larger phase three clinical trials, which have a high proportion of data analytics. And those are higher margin services that we're very focused on expanding in our portfolio. I should say as well that this has all been, of course, achieved, during the pandemic. We haven't been immune to the effects of that. The industry in general has seen fewer new clinical trials starting, apart from obviously lots of new COVID trials, but we're not involved in those. But there has been a slowdown of a startup of new trials this year. But having said that, we've weathered that very well, and obviously demonstrated that in the numbers. But it really reflects the relative size of the market opportunity for us that we address, which I've referred to earlier, but also to a very strong order book that we have. And as of the end of September, that stands at a record level of 21.7 million pounds. And obviously that provides us reassurance going forwards in terms of forward revenue visibility.
Mm-hmm. And we'll maybe come back later to your projections for the future in terms of the market and how perhaps it's changed. But before then, how important a part is innovation playing in IXICO's growth, and what future innovations can we expect from IXICO?
Yeah, so innovation, obviously, we have a very strong record of commercialized innovation. It's not just innovation for the sake of the sciences, if you like. Obviously, we have science very much at the core of what we do, but always with an eye to allowing us to acquire new clients because we have innovative, commercially viable technology. And so each year we track very carefully the contribution of our revenues coming from new products, which we define as a vitality index relative to products we've introduced in the previous 2 years. And so that's a very healthy metric that we monitor. And the reason it's a very important part of our business model is that it actually derives from combining IXICO's expertise in neuroscience, but also a commitment to a very broad network of scientific collaborations that the company is involved with. And these are with academics, but also public-private consortia, including many of the world's pharmaceutical companies that I referred to earlier. And what these collaborations would provide us with is access to unique data sets that is specific to a particular therapeutic area. And so what that allows us to do is to develop unique and proprietary algorithms to actually analyze that data, those brain scans. And then what we do is we then deploy those algorithms to our commercial contracts. And they're used by our clients to identify specific biomarkers associated with, you know, the very wide range of neurological diseases that our clients are looking to develop new drugs for in this era of neurological indications, as I said, such as Alzheimer's and Parkinson's, and also a number of now emerging rare diseases that are becoming very hot topics for the pharmaceutical industry.
Mm-hmm. Now, talking about the global pandemic, COVID-19, it is sadly expected to continue well into 2021. What are your thoughts on the longer term market that IXICO will be looking at, and what does it look like?
Yeah, so I mean, just in terms of the short term, just to emphasize the point, the trials that some of the trials we're expecting towards the end of this year are going to be delayed into 2021. So our growth actually would have been even higher had it not been for the pandemic. But going into the next year and beyond, as I said, we've got a very strong order book for the short term, and we've got a healthy pipeline. But further on, medium to long term, just to make the point, there are two important macro trends that I've referred to previously. One is the fact that the cost of bringing a drug to market is high and is increasing. And so despite levels of outsourcing over the past decade increasing, clinical trials are becoming more complex, and so the return on investment is actually worsening for the pharmaceutical industry rather than bettering. So, of course, they're looking to companies like us to help them not only reduce the risk and uncertainty, but also improve the return on investment for those very expensive clinical trials. And then the second one is that the reason that we're very focused on neuroscience is that there is a global unmet clinical need in neurological diseases. Pharma spend in this area is very high and increasing. As I said, some of the areas such as the rare diseases, we see a lot of investment there as companies try to develop new gene therapies in particular for those indications. But also the second point to make is that, you know, with an aging population, these neurological diseases are going to become a bigger issue. So the already large unmet medical need is only going to get significantly bigger and more urgent. And I guess obviously the most obvious example of that is dementia, which is still the only major cause of death that we can't prevent, slow down, or cure. So Alzheimer's, etc., hasn't gone away. It's going to get bigger and more of an issue. And so that's why, you know, long term, those sort of macro drivers are going to, if anything, increase the requirement for the sort of technology specialist services that IXICO provides.
Excellent. Thank you very much indeed. That's CEO Giulio Cerroni there from IXICO today, joining us here on Proactive London, talking through your financial report and some of your projections for next year. Thank you very much indeed for your time.
My pleasure, Katie. Bye-bye.